So I've come to a property today with the new lad for work experience, Eric. Say hi, Eric.
Hello.
He's behind the camera now. And basically, we've come to an installation to do some testing. It's an empty property, so I thought it was a good idea to maybe get some video footage on earth fault loop impedance testing and maybe some reasons why we have different settings. I use a mega tester, so it'll be 3 lead low, etc., 2 lead high. And we're just going to go over the difference between the two and why we actually use them settings. So as you can see, I've got my tester set to measure my earth fault loop impedance. And as you can see, it comes standard as 3 lead low, okay? We can also change that to 2 lead high. And we can change that to 2 lead low as well. Now, this has become ever more important since the introduction of things like RCDs and RCBOs, and how we have to test them and any issues we may come across if we're trying to test on the wrong set. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna test on the different settings, okay? And then we will look at what happens when we now have RCBOs in the circuit. So I'm gonna start off by using the 2 lead high test, okay? Now we have RCBOs in this installation. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna run this test and see what happens. As you can see, the voltage has appeared, the test won't work, and straight away we have an error and now we have no voltage. And you may not have heard it, the RCBO did trip downstairs. So now we've had the problem of the RCBO tripping, what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna change the setting on our tester from 2 lead high to 3 lead low, okay? Now, the reason we are undertaking it as a 3 lead low now is because the tester is actually going to use another conductor, okay? So we're going to introduce the neutral conductor. So what the tester is going to do is it is going to balance the load current between the line and neutral to protective earth. Therefore, the RCD should not see an imbalance between line and neutral and should not trip and allow us to carry out this test. And as you can see, we have a loop value of 0.89 ohms. So now we've talked about 2 lead high and what that does to an RCBO, 3 lead low, etc. We're just going to switch this now to 2 lead low. Now, the 2 lead low isn't necessarily something you would do on a socket circuit. However, it does have its uses. If you're doing loop testing and let's say you have an RCBO on the circuit or an RCD, and you take off, let's say, a switch cover to test behind that switch cover, sometimes if depending on how it's wired, it may not have a neutral there present. So what you can do is you can use the 2 lead low in the things like light switches where you don't have a neutral, and as you can see, it won't cause the RCBO to trip. It's not necessarily using a neutral conductor now to balance between line and neutral. However, it will be applying a smaller load, so the RCD, and this doesn't work with every RCD, sometimes it will still trip it, depending on how sensitive they are. It'll apply a small load, where it's negligible to the RCD, where it doesn't see it as that imbalance. So again, just a quick recap, okay? Now you see Eric's in shot. So Eric's doing work experience with me. There's a cool story behind that, which we will do a video of at a later date. But just a recap on this really. So if we're thinking about earth fault loop impedance test and the settings we need to be on, we know now that a 2 lead high, okay, or a high current test will actually trip or disconnect an RCD or RCBO. So we generally only use that when we're doing a ZE, okay, when we're doing our external earth fault loop impedance, because we generally don't have in a domestic dwelling an RCD down the circuit. If we're doing socket outlets, generally we have it on a 3 lead low, okay, that will balance the line of neutral and stop the RCD from tripping. And again, for things like light switches where there's not a neutral present, we can use that handy 2 lead low, okay? So Eric, you're a fond watcher of GSH Electrical, aren't you?
Yeah.
So you know what happens at the end of every video? Yeah?
Well, this video has been some help. I know.
That's fine, no, that's fine.
It's a bit of help.